Hello guys, welcome back. And another video on this EGGNS emulator. And on this video, I am going to test the most requested game, Naruto Shippuden 3, Ultimate Ninja 3. And I'm going to test it on this Poco X3 NFC LG B50. Wait, my Xperia XZ2 inside this PSP box. First of all, good morning, good afternoon, and good evening. Wherever you are, stay safe, stay at home, brother. And on this mid-range Redmi Note 7, Redmi Note 8, the only version you can install on these two are version 107. The rest you can't install it. Still finding the problem why it cannot. You can install, but you cannot load the Switch Droid folder. On this Poco X3, I am using version 2.10. On asking for update, cancel. On this XZ2 Snapdragon 845 version 216, different setting from the 210 on this LG V50 using 210 also. Okay, let's begin with the X3 NFC. Okay, setting for the version 210. On version 215, 216. For this Naruto, Naruto Ultimate Ninja 3, you have to use the dock mod. Kena guna dock mod. Kalau tak, screen the blinking. Driver Adreno 530. Oh, on the older version, there is no driver option. 210, 200, 211, they start using the external graphic driver. Okay, let's begin. Naruto Ninja Storm, Ultimate Ninja Storm 3. Snapdragon 732. Version 211, screen blinking. Have to use the dock mod. 210, 200 are better on this game. Speed also okay. If you use the dock mod, see my blinking. Now it's connected. On the game menu, 30 FPS. Poco X3 NFC for the X3 Pro, no problem this game. Yes, too bad now. Realme 5 Pro, Snapdragon 712, I'm not sure. I can't guarantee anything. Snapdragon 732 on Helio G90 6 8 9 10 FPS around that 10 FPS for MediaTek, very bad performance. But on this older version, there is no exit button, no exit option. Okay, let's test on this Xperia. Xperia Android 11, 55% on the brightness. Using Arduino 530. This one version 216. Okay. I'm waiting for the 217, the update. So far they haven't released it. Withdraw on the last minute. So Naruto Ultimate Ninja Storm 3 setting, have to use the dock mod version 211, 215, 216, and this one slow. The FPS, the 2.0.0.2.1.0 are better compared to the 2.1.6. This is the latest build. I'm not sure about 2.1.7. The 2.1.7, I think I read the comment, the performance more or less with the 2.1.6. Not much improvement. Still got a lot of bugs. If you use a dark mode, the screen will not blinking. Disable the dark mode. The screen. Okay. But the dark mode, the resolution upscaled to full HD. Compared to the handheld. Handheld is without the dock mode. Handheld 720p, the resolution are much lower. The speed are better. On the dock mode, full HD, the performance will suffer. Since this game, if you untick the dock mode, the screen will be flickering, blinking. The screen menu on the 20 plus, almost 30. XZ2 Snapdragon 845 Egg NS version 216 Phosphorus. Let me adjust the kernel. DRAM 4 GB already. Still box close. Box close. .7 GB, 4 GB of RAM. Exact two. Have to swap the RAM using the virtual RAM. Compared to PSP, a bit smaller, 4-inch screen. Come on, don't pause, pause. okay now. 20 FPS, same FPS as this Poco X3. See the frame drop when you are using the 216. Snapdragon 732, Poco X3, same FPS using the 210. On 210, I think the FPS almost 30, maybe 20 plus. Okay, next. Oh, 216. Got the exit button. LG V50 Snapdragon 855 version 210. After this, I update it to 216. You will see the difference. Now I'm using 210. Same setting as Poco X3 and FC. Lot of fingerprint, sorry for that. AMOLED. The synchronization. Of the display panel. At 60Hz. Sound. Using a custom ROM on this LG V50 Android 11 Evolution X. This one sure 30 FPS. Naruto vs Naruto. Sasuke.
Take this.
Right.
Here we go.
Seperti ETF perdagangan ETF. Okay, update it to version 216. Use the latest one. On the 210, 30 FPS. Now 216. To 16 if you don't use the dock mode. Slow. You will see the screen flickering, blinking. 215, 211 also, same also. That's what happened, but the FPS are better. Let's try to play the game with this blinking image. Wow, sakit mata tengok. Yo, match. Minimum CPU for playing this Nintendo Switch emulator Snapdragon 855. At least you get a better experience. Even the Snapdragon 845 struggle. At least at 55, 2016, 18 at least. Otherwise, my eyes will spoil. Here, the cache. So, and about the dog mod to reduce the flickering. Try. Okay, that's better. How much FPS? Two one zero, almost 30 FPS. How about 216? LG B50 close, close. Well, that's it. Let's see the Redmi Note 7. This one version 2, well, version 107. Let's say if we update it to a version, to the latest version. Redmi Note 7 Snapdragon 660. See, if I load the folder, destroy. Different folder. Switch. That's the keystone. You hold on, let me copy. Remove the switch right. And copy the latest switch right. Whether it can lock the folder. This is the latest switch, right? Keys out, key, and keys again. Oh, come on, loading. Now, black screen. Snapdragon 835 also like this. 710 also like this, but 712 untuk SD712 saya tak pasti sebab saya tak ada phone tu. 665 Redmi Note 8 sama juga. Sorry, mid-range device. You better get the refurbished LG V50. The price now considered cheap. Maybe 100 plus USD. In Malaysia, 580 ringgit. Mungkin harga akan turun lagi. Ya, bergantung dengan nilai ringgit. Kalau nilai ringgit naik, mungkin harga turun lagi. Okay, itu saja dari saya. Stay tuned for the next video. And once again, thank you for watching.